CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Make yourself at home. Home is where the heart is. Be it ever so humble, there's no place like home. Home. In a single word, there is contained such warmth, such security, such completeness. Say it in 100 languages, its meaning remains unchanged. Home. The place we all come from. And at the same time, the place we spend our lives searching for. To some of us, home is the one place we can never return to.
Well, what's happened to your brother?
Please, Doctor.
Where did he go?
He's gone away.
But he was lying here just a moment ago. He couldn't have disappeared just like that.
I told you where he has gone. He has gone home.
But I just saw him.
He has gone home.
Home? You keep saying home. Well, where is home?
Our mystery drama, All Unregistered Aliens, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Victoria Dan and stars Ann Williams. It is sponsored in part by Contact, the 12-hour cold capsule, and True Value Hardware Stores. I'll be back shortly with Act One. What is the force that drives us to seek our roots? You hear so much talk about such things these days. It seems as if all of America is out there finding themselves. What is the power that can suddenly compel a person to give up material success and return to their old neighborhood? What is so magical about one's place of birth, anyhow? That is, if there is anything magic in the word home at all.
Oh, now, sweetheart. Oh, now, that was just a little vaccination. Remember, please, Mrs. Rodriguez, bring the other children in for their shots by the end of the week. Oh, and be sure to tell your neighbors it's free. The city will pay for all inoculations. Oh, thank goodness it's lunchtime. Inez, is there anyone else waiting to see me? Who? Oh, sure, I certainly can't keep him waiting, can I?
Dr. Anna Quiller?
Yes, what can I do for you, Officer McKeegan?
That's Lieutenant McKeegan. Kind of young to be a doctor, aren't you?
What is it you wanted to see me about, Lieutenant?
Well, I came to welcome you to the neighborhood.
Oh, how very nice of you.
After all, it's an admirable thing you're doing here.
Is it?
Yeah, setting up a free clinic in a neighborhood like this.
A neighborhood like what?
Well, Doctor, let's face it. This isn't exactly paradise.
That would depend on your point of view.
Oh, come on. You don't belong here.
I happen to have been born here.
No kidding.
I was lucky, Lieutenant. I went to college, med school, on a scholarship.
You know, you could be making a lot of money in the suburbs.
I thought you came here to welcome me to this neighborhood.
So I did. Doctor, you know, it's always good community relations to, have citizens cooperate with the police. Especially if they happen to be in the medical profession.
Cooperate how?
Well, for example, wasn't your last patient Nadia Rodriguez?
Well, she brought her baby here for a vaccination. Why are you so interested?
Well, I couldn't care less about Mrs. Rodriguez's baby. On the other hand, didn't you treat her husband Carlos last week?
Who?
Carlos Rodriguez.
Carlos?
A stab wound. Don't you remember?
No, I can't seem to recall.
But I'd just appreciate your reporting interesting injuries to the precinct.
I am a doctor, not a policeman.
You're aware of the problem of street gangs, aren't you?
You do your job, Lieutenant, and I'll do mine.
And gang fights aren't the only problem we got here, Doctor. Do you know how many illegal aliens pass through this neighborhood in just 1 month?
Illegal aliens?
Yeah. They come into the country, stowed away in freight compartments of foreign ships. Thousands of them. No passport, no entry permit. And they're here to stay. Now, you must treat some of these people every day.
You're asking me to report of my patients, Lieutenant.
The word is cooperate with the authorities.
Well, I'd like to thank you for coming by, Lieutenant. Our conversation has been most enlightening.
Are you going to have lunch now, Doctor?
Yes, I am.
Oh, well, it's a great little cafe right across the street run by a fat old guy named Stefan.
I know. He's my uncle.
Oh. Well, look, I was wondering if you...
Goodbye, Lieutenant.
You know what I think? I think you're not eating enough, Anna.
I'm not hungry.
You're not still upset about the visit from Officer McKeegan.
But how did you...
What's ever gone on in this neighborhood I didn't know, little one?
You know what he said, Uncle Stefan?
What?
He said that I didn't belong here. Have you ever heard anything so ridiculous? Uncle? Have you?
Why did you suddenly decide to come back, Anna?
This is my home. I grew up here.
You couldn't wait to leave. As soon as you graduated high school, what made you suddenly decide to come back? I thought you were happy uptown in that fancy office with the carpet and the paintings.
Well, I was, but...
But what?
I suddenly...
Yes?
Oh, I can't explain it. I just knew I had to come back.
Why?
Because I was needed.
Yes. I'm unkind not to tell you that in the few weeks you have been back, you've done only good. You are needed here. I'm proud of my niece, Anna. That's what my head says. But my heart says my brother's child should have the best. What kind of men can you meet here? You should have a house with a lawn and trees and flower boxes. Swings for the children.
Oh, Uncle. Oh, what in heaven's name?
Oh, more glasses again.
That poor bus boy.
Shh. I don't want to hurt his feelings.
Mr. Quiller, I am so very sorry for this accident.
Never mind, Eli. It's all right.
I am not to be discharged?
No, Eli. Just clean up the broken pieces.
Yes, you're very kind, Mr. Quiller. Really, very kind.
Just a minute, Eli. Where is your cousin? I thought this was supposed to be his shift.
I do not know.
It isn't right, Eli, taking his place all the time. You work hard enough as it is.
Well, he's young, Mr. Quiller. He wants to be with his friends. I try to tell him they're bad company, but he does not listen.
What were we talking about, Anna?
Still doing it, aren't you, Uncle Stefan?
What?
One man, Salvation Army. Taking in refugees, giving them jobs.
Now, little one, don't think I'm a charity ward.
No? But just look at that man, Eli. I've never seen such a down-and-out expression on anyone.
Yes, well, things were pretty bad for him in his old country. Anyhow, just so you don't think I'm running a charity ward, you ought to see the mural Eli's doing for my office. You know, he's quite an artist. Why don't you come
back? Look at the time. I'd better get back to the clinic.
Well, you really should see his painting.
Maybe later, Uncle. Maybe later. Inez, why don't you go now? Sure, I can lock up. See you tomorrow. Well, let's see. Where did I put... Who could that be at the back door?
Oh, just a minute. All right, I'm coming. You should use the regular entrance in front.
Doctor.
Yes, you're Eli, the busboy, but who?
It is my cousin. Please, doctor, can you help him?
Well, of course, bring him in. What happened?
Please, where should I put him?
On the bed, there. Easy now.
Eli.
He's been shot.
Eli, I'm sorry.
Oh, now, keep still. Bring me the solution to that bottle by the sink.
Yes, of course. It hurts. It hurts bad.
Now, please, don't try to talk.
Doctor, how bad is it?
It's bad.
Is he going to...
What is your cousin's name?
Cleo. I told him not to go around with those boys, but he wouldn't listen to me.
Where are you, Eli?
No, I'm right here, Cleo.
I'm sorry about tonight. We went to the warehouse. They said it was an initiation. Something went wrong. Eli, there was a man, an old man. He shot at us. We ran. I'm sorry.
No, it's all right.
No. It was bad what we were going to do. I didn't understand then. I only wanted him to like me.
Never mind.
I wanted to belong.
I know, Cleo, I know.
I can't do anything else for him. It's too late.
Cleo.
I want to go home.
This is home.
No, I want to go back. Back to our real home.
But Cleo,
I want to die. On my own soil.
No, listen to me. You are not going to die.
I am. You know I am. Don't let me die here. Please. I want to go home.
Doctor, could you leave us alone now, please?
But I...
You said there was nothing more you could do for him.
Yes. I'll be right outside.
Cleo. Can you hear me?
I want to go home. Go home. Send me home.
To go home, you must listen for the wind.
Yes. The wind. The wind will carry me home.
Think of the wind.
Eli, where am I? I'm lost.
Find the wind, cousin. Find the wind.
Wait. I hear it. I hear the wind. I'm going home, Hila. The wind is taking me home. Home.
Goodbye, cousin. Goodbye. Forever. Dr. Quiller?
Your cousin, is he...
Cleo is gone.
I'm very sorry. I'd better go in and... Where is he?
I already told you.
But you said he was dead.
I said he was gone.
Well, how? He was dying. He didn't have the strength to move.
He found the strength.
Oh, that's impossible. What's happened to him?
I told you he's gone.
Well, where did he go?
Where?
Tell me. Where did he go? Where?
He has gone home, Doctor. He has gone home.
Well, that's a simple enough answer. Of course, you and I know that if Dr. Anna Quiller believes that settles that. We wouldn't have a second act. And consider this. I, for one, am rather curious about where Cleo went myself. I intend to find out where exactly home is when we return in just a few minutes with Act Two. are many people in this world who do not like to become involved in the lives of others around them. And, after all, there is something to be said for the uneventful but also safe habit of minding one's own business. But Dr. Anna Quiller, who has returned to her childhood slum neighborhood to open a clinic, has chosen the path of curiosity and concern. A young man, fatally injured in a warehouse prank, has disappeared from her examination room. And his older cousin calmly remarks that the young man has simply gone home.
But how could he have gone anyway? He was dying from that bullet wound.
I must go now.
No. I want answers. That was a mortal wound. The damage was irreparable. That boy had only moments to live.
Yes, you are right. He had only moments to live.
Then how did he leave?
How?
You said he went home.
He was carried, of course.
But carried by whom?
By the wind.
What?
That is, friends. Several friends came in through the alley and...
No, you're lying. No. None of this makes any sense. Why were you in such a hurry to get rid of Cleo?
Do not speak that way. It is ugly.
Oh, I understand everything now.
Do you?
If your cousin had died in my presence, I would have to sign a death certificate.
Death certificate?
Oh, don't play dumb. You know what I'm driving at.
But I do not.
You had to get rid of your cousin's body because I would have had to call the police. And that would mean trouble, wouldn't it?
Oh, I do not...
You certainly do understand. You and Cleo are both in this country illegally. Do you deny it?
No, I do not deny it.
If the police came here and found Cleo's body, it would be over for you. You'd be deported.
It would be over, but not the way you believe.
Well, don't you see? It's no use. The authorities will find out as soon as you try to bury him.
He will not be buried.
What?
Cleo will not be buried. He is no longer in this city.
But you said he was home.
He is.
You said he had been carried home.
To his real home. Not to the dirty little room in his adopted land, but home. True home.
Wait, just a minute.
Back home to where he was born. His native soil.
You sent him home? Literally? Like on a boat?
Well, that is
what you mean, isn't it?
Yes, that is what I mean, Doctor. Now, I must go.
No, wait. We still have to talk.
About what?
I mean, your cousin was involved in the shooting. I have to tell...
Tell who?
The police are going to want to know.
Well, why must you tell anyone what happened here tonight?
But...
It is hard for me to hide my pain. Without Cleo, I am alone. So alone. But I must go on. So I ask you for your help.
But I have to inform them...
When I first brought Cleo here, I was not sure if he would die. If there was any hope, I wanted to help him. The people in the neighborhood, they say... You can trust the doctor. She is okay.
Believe me, I don't want to get you in trouble, but...
So, you will not say anything. I trust you still.
Oh, Harry, make that one coffee black to go.
Well, if it isn't Dr. Quiller. Good morning.
Is it?
The usual with the Danish, Harry. You look like you didn't get much sleep last night, Doctor.
Oh, you're mistaken. Thank you, Harry.
Could you wait a minute? I want to ask you something.
Lieutenant, I've got a room full of people at the clinic.
Yeah, well, this will only take a minute.
All right. What is it?
Did you have any late-night visitors last night?
Is that any of your business?
I don't know what you're talking about. I mean at the clinic. And that is my business.
No, I didn't have any late-night visitors at the clinic, Lieutenant.
So, what time did you close up?
The usual time.
Which is?
9:30.
Really? What happened to the kid with the bullet wound?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, now, didn't we have another discussion like this once? Now, listen, Doctor. There was a warehouse robbery last night. The watchman said he got one of the kids. Who did you treat late last night?
Nobody.
You really think you're doing a noble thing, don't you? Well, you're not doing these kids a favor, you know. All you do is glue them together so they can go right out again and commit worse crimes.
Spare me the lectures, McKeegan.
You tell me something, Doc. Huh? I'm just trying to do my job in a neighborhood like this, and it isn't easy. Why are you making me the heavy, huh?
I'm sorry. I don't mean to snap at you. In a way, you're right, but in a way, you're also wrong. You can go around doing the arresting. That's your job. My job is to help whoever walks through the door of that clinic.
What was the name of the kid the night watchman shot?
Now, officer, how would I know?
What are you doing here so early in the day, Anna?
Well, I have to talk to you, Uncle Stefan.
You did not sleep last night.
Really shows, doesn't it?
Come, we talk better in my office. All right, we talk.
Uncle?
Come, sit in the soft chair here.
Uncle? This wall.
Oh. You like the mural Eli's painting, eh?
I never saw anything quite like it.
Oh, well, art is a matter of taste.
I don't understand what it's supposed to be.
Well, it's supposed to be a picture.
A picture of what?
Landscape.
Oh, sure is weird. The colors it uses, it's almost creepy.
It makes you feel afraid?
Oh, no, no, not afraid, just strange. Huh, can't explain it. Oh, listen, Uncle, I've got to ask your advice.
About poor Cleo?
Boy, you do know everything, don't you?
So young, but so foolish, so reckless.
Eli said he sent Cleo's body home.
That would be right.
Uncle, all my life you've helped people that came through here. You never talked about it. But I'm curious. I want to know about these people.
What people?
You sound like me talking to Lieutenant McKeegan, Uncle. Look, what country did Cleo and Eli come from?
Country?
Yeah, I'm curious. I know it's somewhere in Eastern Europe, but I can't place the accent.
I wouldn't exactly call it a country.
A state?
No.
A place can be pretty small and still be a country. Tell me the name.
Melagania. Ever hear of it?
Melagania? Can't say it rings a bell. I'll have to look it up in my old high school atlas.
Oh, you won't find it there.
Why not?
Well, you see, they just granted it sovereignty.
Oh.
What's troubling you?
Well, that's what I really wanted to talk to you about. I treated Cleo in my office last night.
Where else would the poor boy have gone?
Well, I can't forget the picture of him. So young, so beyond hope. Lying on that bed in my clinic.
Anna, you are a doctor. Death is not new to you.
It never stops hurting. No matter how many times you see it. And this time, I can't explain it. I felt an even deeper hurt.
Because he was so young.
Perhaps that's it. Uncle Stefan, I don't know what to do. I've got Lieutenant McKeegan following me around.
Is that so bad? I hear he's a college man.
Well, I don't mean that, Uncle. He's following me, trying to get me to talk about Cleo.
I know.
Oh, you know everything. But do you know how I can get out of this? Sooner or later, McKeegan's going to trip me up and I'll accidentally say something.
Don't always act as if you had something to hide, little one. That is why Lieutenant suspects you.
You're probably right.
Is something wrong?
Melgania is the name, you say?
Yes.
That mural. Something very peaceful about that sky. So blue. Unreal kind of blue, like the water in the Mediterranean. Is that supposed to be Melgania?
Yes. And I will be truthful. I worry about you. You work. You never have any fun. I joke before about McKeegan, but there is a danger. In a way, he is right.
But Uncle Stefan, he says...
One day, a very dangerous person could walk into the clinic. Maybe the type who doesn't trust doctors.
I'm not afraid.
You're like a fish out of water here.
Only because you keep telling me I am. But I'm not.
What do you really want to do here?
I want to help.
A doctor helps anywhere.
It has to be here.
What is so special about here?
What's the matter, Uncle? Why are you acting this way?
I only want to...
To what?
Protect you.
Oh, Uncle. Protect me from what?
From...
From what?
Once you become involved, there will be no turning back.
Oh, Uncle, you're not making any sense.
Your life will never be the same again.
Uncle Stefan, I don't understand what you're trying to say.
I help immigrants. Why not? I was one myself. Anyone comes to my door, they say, help me, I say yes. No one do I turn away.
Why are you talking in riddles?
They need food, a place to stay, a job. Okay, I help them. Most of them, they're in the country without papers. They come from Russia, from Hungary, Romania. Some I don't ask, I don't know. But Eli and Cleo, they're different.
How is that?
They're not human.
Oh, now
they
really?
They are not human because they come from Melgania.
What are you saying?
Anna, Melgania is not another country. It is another world.
You're kidding, aren't you?
I'm serious. Melgania exists, but not on Earth.
Now, just wait a minute. Did he say what we think he said? Another world? But of course, it can only happen on this program. After all, our listeners have become very open-minded. Another country, another world. What does it matter? To the refugee in a foreign land, isn't the feeling of strangeness the same? I'll be back in a moment with Act Three. Tired, you're poor, the inscription on the Statue of Liberty begins. More than any other country in the world, America has remained a haven for a world of immigrants. But is it conceivable that our reputation as a land of opportunity is more widespread than we would normally believe? Maybe in worlds beyond this one, people have heard the call. Perhaps Melganians are one example.
Uncle Stefan, that's absurd. How can Eli be from another world?
Is it so impossible?
Yes.
Why?
Because it is, that's all.
Melganians look human, but they aren't.
You don't expect me to believe any of this, do you?
There's one difference between Melganians and humans. When they die, their bodies disintegrate almost right away.
They what?
Their bodies disappear.
Where'd you get that old wives' tale?
You know why you could not sleep last night? It was because you knew something very strange had happened to Cleo's body.
It wasn't really strange.
You cannot even explain how Cleo was gone so quickly.
Well, Eli said some friends came and then...
But you didn't believe him, did you?
No. Not at first. But the more I thought about it...
You did not believe it. Because there are certain instincts that tell us something is not so.
All right, maybe I didn't believe him. But I couldn't think of another explanation.
I just gave one to you. Little one, there are powers you know nothing about.
Oh, hey, it can't be 10 o'clock already.
Anna, you must listen to me.
Look, Uncle Stefan, I am in no mood for the old mumbo-jumbo about the forces that be.
Anna, you did not just decide to come back here to this neighborhood. You were summoned.
Uncle, I really don't have time for this.
I say you were summoned.
Summoned? By whom?
I don't know.
Oh, well, when you find out, let me know. Meanwhile, I've got to get back to work.
Dr. Quiller.
Eli, I have a question to ask you.
Oh, please, please, please come inside. Would you like a glass of water?
Eli, I don't want anything.
Oh.
I just want to ask, what have you been telling my uncle?
Mr. Quiller, I tell him nothing.
You've been using Uncle Stefan.
Using?
Don't pretend you don't understand. What kind of nonsense is this about Malgania?
You know about Malgania?
Don't look so surprised. He told me about it.
You know?
I think he really believes that Malgania is another world.
But it is.
Oh, is that a fact?
You are mocking me.
You used me, too, with Cleo.
You are not to say such things.
Why not? They're true, aren't they?
I was not afraid of the police. All Cleo asked for was the wind on which to ride home. If a man should die before his time, if a man should die away from home, let him listen for the wind. Let him find the winds of home, and he shall be carried back again to his rest.
You really believe that, don't you?
Why shouldn't I? It is true.
If Cleo couldn't wait to go home, why did you leave in the first place?
Well, why does anyone leave a homeland? Why did your people come to America?
Because they were persecuted.
Yes, well, it is the same all over. I go where I am allowed to paint the things I wish to paint, not what a high council tells me I must.
You really believe you come from another planet, don't you?
No.
Ah, oh, we're getting somewhere.
No, a planet is on the same plane as your Earth. My world is here, but in another, you would call it dimension.
Oh, boy.
I thought you understood at first, but you do not.
Eli, I think you would enjoy talking to a friend of mine who helps in matters such as...
No. No more help. Where was the help we needed when we first came here? Help from others who have gone before us.
There are others like you?
They were to be here, waiting to help us.
But Uncle Stefan helped you.
Yes, he is kind, but he is not one of us. What happened to them? Why did they desert us?
Oh, well, wait a minute. Why are you looking at me like that?
You are here to help me.
Oh, now, hold on.
Yes. Yes. Your eyes.
What about my eyes?
I see it in your eyes. Yes.
I don't know what you see, but you see wrong. I just came here to tell you.
You came here to tell me, Anna, that I had a friend, a new friend.
I was talking about my uncle. That's why I came here. You can't go around telling stories about...
You are my new friend.
I mean, about coming from another world and bodies disintegrating. You don't think anyone would believe this.
Yes, yes. You will help me.
No, I can't.
You must help me.
Help you?
It is so strange and new here, Anna. It is so lonely. Back in Malgania, I was brave. I was strong. But this world, it is so alien. It's so gray, so vast, so terrifying. It turned me from a man into a child.
What am I supposed to do to help you?
There is a door between our worlds. Those who pass through it promised they would make a home for the others who would one day also travel through the door.
Well, speaking of doors, I think it's time I was leaving.
But those who came before Cleo and me, they were not here. They must perhaps be dead.
Goodbye, Eli.
No, wait. Where are you going?
You need help all right, Eli, but from a different kind of doctor.
No, please, listen. I must explain to you. You must understand.
Oh, look, let go of my arm.
No, you are the only one who can understand. You are the only one who can help me.
Why won't you believe me? Why won't you listen to the truth?
You're hurting my arm.
There is a Malgania. There is another world.
No, it's just a delusion. It's impossible. There can't be any such places.
Can it be so frightening, the truth? Can it be so horrible?
I don't want to talk about this anymore. Now let me go.
What do you know of loneliness? In years, we are the same age. But half my life, I am in a cell without windows to see the colors of life. No sound of another voice.
You were in prison?
Yes, and my only crime is to paint what is in my heart. But without sunlight, the heart becomes old and withered. The years go by, and one day I am no longer brave or strong. And they let me go at last. Because they have won. Inside, I am only gray and empty.
You were in jail?
Yes, for 15 years. Oh, I remember the good Malgania. How it was before the evil ones had such power. Maybe one day it will be beautiful again. But not for many lifetimes. My lifetime must be spent here. Look at me, Anna.
No.
I am only asking you to be my friend. To help me understand about this new world. Look at me. At my eyes. They tell the truth.
Can't be.
Can it be you see, Malgania?
No. No, I don't see anything.
Is that what your heart tells you? Is that what my touch tells you?
Why are you doing this to me? I don't understand.
Tell me now I am wrong. Tell me now that you do not believe me. Tell me and I will never again bother you, Anna.
I believe you. But why? Why do I believe you?
You will be my friend, Anna?
Eli, I will be your friend.
Say, Mr. Quiller, I think I'll have another one of those great sandwiches today.
Yeah, of course, Lieutenant of the Keegan. It's my pleasure.
Uncle Stefan, I've got to talk. Oh.
Oh, Doctor. How are you? Well, you look a bit upset.
Oh, no, not at all, Lieutenant. Not at all. I was just in a hurry to get my lunch.
Hey, I'm glad I ran into you. I wanted to ask you some questions, and
Questions? About what?
This busboy working for your uncle. What's his name? Eli?
What about Eli?
Never mind, then. I take care of this. Here, a napkin for your sandwich, Lieutenant McKeegan. I tell you about Eli.
Hmm?
He's a refugee from the old country.
Oh, is that right?
Yes. Yes, he's from the old country.
Well, I don't believe he has any papers.
He does not have any papers.
Uncle!
But that is because he is a political prisoner in the old country. He escapes with help of underground.
Hey, I'm not a hard-hearted guy, Mr. Quiller. Now, I don't want to send somebody back to one of those totalitarian states where they're going to get tortured, but look.
The law is the law, and you won't bend it, right?
Well, yeah, that's right.
As I recall, Lieutenant, if an alien has family in this country, authorities tend to be more lenient.
Oh, come on. That guy doesn't have any relatives here.
Ah, but you're wrong. I am my nephew's legal guardian.
Your nephew? That guy Eli is your nephew?
He is nephew of Anna's mother, my sister-in-law.
Doctor, is that true?
My uncle does not lie, Lieutenant.
Ah, well, this makes the situation different.
It does?
Yeah, I mean, he's a relative of yours, and I...
You what?
Look, I'm not such a bad guy, Doc. I mean, legally, there are ways to get around. Well, what I'm saying is, I can bend the rules sometimes, too.
You will not.
Wrap up my sandwich, will you, Mr. Quiller? I better be going.
You believe me?
Well, let's put it this way, Doc. I believe you. But one day...
One day what?
One of these days, you're going to run out of cousins.
He believed me, Uncle.
I suppose he wanted to believe you.
Yes, but I lied. I feel terrible.
You didn't lie.
Oh, come on, Uncle Stefan.
Okay, so we lied about Eli being your cousin, but...
But what?
We don't know that for sure, do we?
Wait a minute.
On the other hand, your mother never said she didn't have a sister. Who knows? Maybe he really is your cousin.
Uncle, what are you saying?
You always assumed that your mother and my brother came from the same country.
But they did.
No. Your father and I met your mother when she came into this city. Alone. Not a friend in the world. She talked about a door. We didn't understand then. When she died, I decided to let that be the end of it. But the call of the blood is too strong. You came back to help one of your own.
You mean that I...
And you will help Eli. And maybe one day, others will come through that door.
My mother was from Melkania?
But Anna, you must have known it all the time.
Did she know it all the time? Is blood, as they say, really thicker than water? Was that the force driving Anna Quiller back to her old neighborhood from the beginning? Or do you believe that there is no place called Melgania, and Stefan and Anna are victims of an incredible hoax? In the long run, does it really matter where anybody comes from? I'll be back shortly. Do people believe what they want to believe? Or perhaps there is a greater truth that the eyes will not accept, yet the heart knows must be. We credit logic with the mind, but what about the logic of that inner self? For in the end, do we not usually choose to act with the heart and not with the head? Our cast included Anne Williams, Court Benson, and Earl Hammond. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.